I welcome you all for the series of lecture on metrology. Now we will start the module number 12. In this module, we will be discussing about advanced metrology. In this module, we will be discussing about the following topics under advanced metrology. So we will be discussing about universal measuring machine, coordinate measuring machine, what are the softwares used in CMMs, and then we will move on to laser vision, in-process gauging, stage position metrology, and then we will be discussing about the instrumentations used in nanotechnology. And then we will discuss about the testing and certification services. Finally, we will discuss about complex optomechanical assemblies. Now, under module number 12, we will start lecture 1. In this lecture, we will be discussing about various aspects of universal measuring machine and coordinate measuring machine. Now, in the previous modules, we discussed about various metrological instrumentation like micrometer, vernier caliper, dial indicators, protractors, depth gauges, microscope, etc., etc. These instruments are used mostly to check one feature of the workpiece. For example, micrometer is used to measure the thickness of the workpiece or the length of the workpiece, and then protractors are used to measure the angle between two surfaces. Similarly, depth gauges are used to measure the depth of holes like this. Now, a measuring machine has been devised which can be used to measure the many features of the workpiece in one setting. So this device is known as universal measuring machine. So it is used to quantify inside and outside dimensions like length, diameter, center distance between holes, and it can be used to measure angles between the two surfaces of the workpiece. It can also be used to check the thread parameters of inside and outside threads. It can be used to inspect hard workpieces made of hard materials, or it can also be used to measure the features of soft materials. It is normally used to calibrate all types of standards, for example, plug gauges, ring gauges, thread plug gauges, thread ring gauges, etc., can be calibrated using this universal measuring machine. Now we can see the pictures of universal measuring machine. We have the base of the measuring machine, normally made of cast iron. We can see the guideways. So these are the flat guideway and V inverted V guideway on which the table moves. Now I can see when the table moves in this particular direction, it is moving in the X direction, that is longitudinal movement of the table, and when the measuring head moves in this particular direction, it is transverse direction or movement in the Y direction, and this is the measuring head which can be moved up and down. So this is the vertical travel of the measuring head. We can mount the different probes to the measuring head to carry out the inspection of the workpieces. You can see the objectives through which eyepieces through which we can take the readings, and a circular table can be mounted on this table for measurement of features like angles. We can see the hand wheels to achieve the motion in X, Y and Z direction. Now let us study what are the features of universal measuring machine. A large variety of accessory supports and probes can be mounted onto the universal measuring machine to check both internal and external features of the workpieces. The measuring force is assured by means of an adjustable air system which can be regulated to different pressures. So by adjusting the by maintaining different pressures, the measuring force can be maintained. So this system eliminates errors which could be caused by varying the operator feel. Because of use of this air system, the operator feel is excluded from the inspection process. Now, computer support is available for acquiring, processing, logging and transmitting measurement data. The measurement can be made using the probe, different kinds of probes, and data is transmitted to the computer system which has a software which will analyze the data and gives the required results. ISO compliant printout of measurement data is possible, and the different kinds of accessories are available which can be mounted onto the universal measuring machine to assist the inspection of very complex workpieces. Form stability is achieved through a sturdy machine base made of cast iron or granite, and there is high resistance to wear through carbide reinforced measuring surfaces. All the surfaces which are subjected to friction or the wear are covered by carbide reinforced measuring surfaces. So CCD camera attachment is also possible. All the moving parts, they have a very good parallelism within plus or minus 1 micrometer, and direct display of all measured values is possible, and we have a display of minimum and maximum hold values. We can select the English system or metric system depending upon our requirement, and what is the measuring force currently used, that also can be displayed. Because of this arrangement, operator feel is eliminated, and it is possible to introduce up to 9 preset values in the universal measuring machine. Now, multi window modes are available on the screen. And then on-screen video help for measuring functions is possible. For example, a particular function is selected, the on-screen help is available so that the operator can use all the functions without much difficulty. Touchscreen display is also possible, and the measurement in absolute and comparative mode is possible. Now, what are the specifications of these universal measuring machine. So different sizes of universal measuring machines are available in the range of 100 to 500 millimeter, and 0 to 1000 millimeter is possible in this is x direction movement, and in the y direction movement 100 millimeter, and in the z travel 150 millimeter. So like this, the universal measuring machines are different sizes are available, and resolution can be switched depending upon the accuracy requirement. We can select the appropriate resolution, like 1 micrometer or 0.1 micrometer or 100th micrometer. Like this, resolutions can be switched, and it naturally requires a controlled temperature room for the operation of UMM. And the measuring force can be adjusted between 1 to 12 newtons depending upon the type of workpiece. And the displacement speed of the carriage or the table movement, we can select up to 1.5 meter per second. Such a high speed is possible. And very fine adjustment range is possible between 0 to 10 millimeter. And then the operational temperature limit is from 10 to 40 degrees Celsius, and operational humidity limit is 30 to 80%, and repeatability we can achieve up to 0.1 micrometer. The machine weight will be between 80 to 200 kg depending upon the size of the machine. Now various accessories are commercially available which can be mounted to universal measuring machine. That is the work table of cast iron is possible, or granite is possible, and glass tables are also available which can be mounted on to the machine table. Circular rotary table can be mounted to assist the measurement of angles, and then center supports are available to mount the cylindrical workpieces. And then work holding devices for end measurements are possible. A dividing head can be mounted, and reference plugs are available for checking racks. And display unit can be either analog type or digital indicator type. And collimator for illumination from below to measure contours, radii, hole diameter, etc. is possibility. Optical system can be attached to the universal measuring machine. And locating microscopes, goniometric microscopes can be attached to the machine to measure angles. Different kinds of probes can be attached, and the universal measuring head is also available. A single V-support, adjustable V-supports can be used, and holders can be mounted for checking the knives or for holding the knives for inspection. And then attachment for measurement between transversal anvils is also possible, and lapping equipment also can be used for lapping purpose. And then user friendly software to select testing procedure, resolution and probe time. A set of two prisms can be mounted for measurement of threads, and then calibrated wires can be used for measurement of thread pitches. Special tool holders can be used depending upon the requirement, and attachment for measuring the pitch of internal threads, and microscope for measuring the diameter of internal threads can be attached. And then thread profile heads, taper measurement attachment, all these are possible with universal measuring machine. Now you can see some of the commercially available universal measuring machines. You can see the base on which the other attachments are mounted. This is the table on which workpiece can be mounted, and the table can be moved in the longitudinal as well as transverse direction. And these spindles are housed in the housing. These housings can be moved in this direction to accommodate the workpieces of different lengths. And then the wheels are provided for moving the table. We can also, digital display is also possible depending upon the movement of the spindle. So what is the movement can be read out from the digital displays. And then you can see the digital display and the keyboard is also available for setting the preset values. And probes can be attached to the spindles for measurement of internal dimensions. And then you can see here the ID measurement of ring gauge by two probes. That means the ring gauge to be measured is placed on the table as shown here. This is the ring gauge mounted on the table, and probes are fixed to these two spindles. By moving the probes, we can check what is the internal diameter of the ring gauge. Similarly, we can measure the outside diameter of the ring gauges. And here, ID measurement of ring gauge using a single probe, so that we can see. And then the display unit also, you can see digital display unit, and OD measurement of plug gauge. So, and here you can see a digital display. So when we move the probes, what is the amount of movement is displayed on the digital display. And finally, we can take out the inspection report using the printers. Now, presently, universal measuring machines are replaced by coordinate measuring machines. Now, let us move to the discussion on coordinate measuring machine. Under this topic, we will be discussing the following points. What is the need for faster inspection, and some basics about coordinate measuring machine, like what are the different modes of operation of CMM, what are the different configurations available in CMM, and how do we how to conduct preventive maintenance of CMM. And then we will discuss about the recent advancement in CMM, that is portable CMM and virtual metrology. Now let us understand what is the need for faster inspection. Now we have discussed in length about micrometer, vernier calipers, dial indicators, protractors, etc., etc., which are used to measure the various features of workpieces. And these devices, metallurgical devices, are used to measure only the single feature of the workpiece. For example, micrometer is used to measure length of the workpiece or thickness of the workpiece. So like that. And for measuring the different features of the workpiece, we need to have a large inventory of instruments, metrological instruments, and with the different ranges, different accuracies, etc. So the metrological instrumentation inventory will be too large. And since we have to use different kinds of instruments to measure the various features of the workpiece, the time taken for the inspection of the workpiece is too large. Now, there is a growing need for a device that can do faster, fast piece inspection, and many times 100% dimensional inspection. In view of this, a device is constructed which is known as coordinate measuring machine, which is a sort of advancement in universal measuring machine. So this coordinate measuring machine plays a vital role in the mechanization of the inspection process. We can mechanize the inspection process in the sense, in the production line itself, the CMM can be introduced, and as soon as the workpiece is made, it is shifted to the table of CMM and inspection can be carried out, and feedback can be given to the software for making necessary corrections in the program if there is any deviation in the workpiece. Now let us study some basics of CMM. Similar to universal measuring machine, a coordinate measuring machine is a device used for measuring the physical geometrical characteristics of an object. This machine may be manually controlled by an operator, or it may be a computer controlled machine. Data collection system is used along with the CMM, and data collection system typically includes a machine controller to control the movements of CMM, and there is a desktop computer which has a software to take the data points and to analyze the data points, and after analysis of the data points, it gives the inspection report. Measurements are made by a probe attached to the third axis of the machine, which is known as z-axis of the machine. Now we can see a stylus attached to the probe head of CMM. So this stylus will move into the hole and it makes contact with the surface of the workpiece, and then again it is moved in this direction, and then again the contact is made. Now when it makes contact with the workpiece at this point, the XYZ coordinates of this particular location is given to the computer. Similarly, XYZ coordinates of this particular location is given to the computer, and the software it calculates what is the distance between these two surfaces. Similarly, the diameter of the hole can be found out by making contacts at three points, and using the data points of the coordinates of these three data points, software will calculate what is the location of the center point, and then it calculates what is the diameter of the workpiece. Like this, by using various subroutines, the features of workpiece can be assessed. Now, the probes attached to the CMM may be mechanical type or optical type. By using the mechanical type of probes, we can measure the various features by making contact with the workpiece surface. In case of optical probe, there is no contact between the optical probe and the workpiece, so it is a non-contact type of measurement. And probes move laterally, that is in the x and y direction, x direction and y direction, and probe also moves in vertical direction, that is z direction, and the data points are recorded. Coordinate measuring machines consist of a platform, that is a work table on which the workpiece being measured is placed. If depending upon the requirement, maybe a fixture is used to mount the workpiece, or the workpiece can be directly placed on the work table for measurement purpose without using any fixture if it is a simple workpiece. Then they are versatile in their capability to record a measurement of very complex profiles with high sensitivity and speed. Whenever we need to measure the complex profiles, we can use a scanning type of mechanical probe which will move along the surface, and then data points are recorded, and then the profile can be evaluated. Now, these CMM machines can be placed very close to the machine tool for efficient inspection and rapid feedback for correction of processing parameter before the next part is made. That is, workpieces need not be moved to metrology lab. CMMs can be moved to the place where machining is going on. That is, CMMs can be installed in the production line itself. So as soon as the part is produced, it can be inspected. They are made more rugged to resist environmental effects in manufacturing plants, such as temperature variations, vibration, and dirt. If temperature variation is there, or if there is vibration, so automatic compensation is made using necessary software. Now let us see how the CMM looks like. I can see this is the table. It can be a granite table or a cast iron table, which has a flatness of a fraction of a micrometer. And on this table, we can mount the workpiece directly. It can be placed on the work table surface itself, or if necessary, a fixture can be used to mount the workpiece. And then we have two, in this particular configuration, we have two columns. This is column 1 and column 2. These two columns move on the move along the y-axis by using the ball screw and appropriate drives. You can see there is a dust cover to cover the ball screw so that dust will not accumulate on the lead screw. So at this place, the column number 1 will be moving on the granite surface. So there will be air jets below this column surface, so that it moves frictionlessly. Between these two columns, there is a bridge, and this bridge carries the probe head, and we can mount the different kinds of probes to this probe head, and this probe head can move vertically up and down the z-axis by using the appropriate drive system. We can move the stylus in X, Y, and Z direction by operating the joystick. You can see the joystick, and we can various subroutines are available. We can select the subroutines by using this keypad. For example, measurement of diameter of a hole, or the angle between two surfaces. Like this, appropriate subroutine is selected, and then the data points are collected. We can observe a stylus stand here directly mounted on the surface of the granite table. This stylus stand holds the stylus of different sizes and different shapes. Depending upon the inspection requirement, the stylus is selected automatically. It is fixed to the probe head, and then measurement is carried out. Now, what are the features of a coordinate measuring machine? Now, you can observe that a typical CMM is composed of three axes, X axis, Y axis and Z axis. These axes are orthogonal to each other in a typical three-dimensional coordinate system to give maximum rigidity to the machines without excessive weight. All the moving members, that is bridge structure, Z-axis carriage and Z-columns are made of hollow box construction. Each axis has a scale system, maybe a linear scale or rotary encoders to indicate the location of that particular axis. The machine will read the input from the touch probe or mechanical probe or an optical probe as directed by the operator or CNC program. The machine then uses the XYZ coordinates of each of these points to determine size and position with micrometer precision. Now, air bearings are provided for ensuring friction-free travel. In these, compressed air is forced through a series of very small holes. For example, so we have a granite work table and then the column. So column, in the case of moving column type, column will be moving. So here, air jets will be there. So I'll just enlarge this portion. This is the table surface and this is the bottom of column. So here, small holes are provided through which compressed air is allowed to pass. So air will be escaping like this. So because of this arrangement, the columns will move frictionlessly. Optional rotary tables can be used to enhance the approachability of the measuring probe to complicated work pieces. In the case of advanced CMMs, they have their own computers with interactive dialogue facility and friendly software so that the workpieces can be inspected with least effort. And then a map of systematic errors in machine is built up and fed into the computer system so that the error compensation is built up into the software. Various thermocouples are incorporated throughout the machine and interface with the computer for making the thermal compensation. If there is any variation in the temperature, the thermal compensation is provided by the software. Now, what are the different modes of operation? Now, CMMs are available which have manual mode, and in this case it has a free floating probe. The operator moves the XYZ axis manually to establish contact with the part feature to be measured. The differences in scale readings among the contact points are then are the measurements. Now you can see this particular picture, the granite table and the workpiece, and then the column, bridge, etc. Now you can see the operator is holding the probe head and he manipulates the probe. That means manually he moves the probe to make contact with the workpiece. For example, this is the probe, and then we have a workpiece which has a step like this. So the operator moves the probe and he makes contact with this particular surface, and he records what is the reading, and then he lifts the probe, and then it is moved in this direction, and again it is moved down, and again the contact is made between the probe and the workpiece surface. What is the reading is recorded, then the difference between these two readings is calculated, which will give what is the depth of this step. Like this, manually the probe is moved and contact is made with the workpiece feature, readings are recorded, and the required value is manually calculated. So this consumes a lot of time, and maybe operator may make some mistakes by calculating. And the advancement over manual mode is manual computer assisted mode. In this case, electronic digital displays are provided to CMM. We can observe here a monitor is provided, which indicates the data points. So electronic digital displays are added to CMM for making zero setting to select the required system, in system or metric system, to print data in the standard format. These features, that is computer assistance, saves time, minimizes calculations, and reduces errors. Now we can also see this is a shop floor CMM. You can see the CMM is mounted on this table, which has wheels. So wherever measurement is required, we can move this coordinate measuring machine with the help of these wheels, and then the measurement can be made. Now let us watch a demonstration of a manual coordinate measuring machine, which has a built-in electronic digital display. So in this demonstration, we can see the CMM with X, Y, Z movements. The three movements are manual. That means the operator has to hold the axis and he has to move by applying force, manual force. There is a digital readout interfaced with CMM. This digital readout shows the selected coordinates of the selected data points, and it also shows the results. The software in the electronic system has many subroutines. We can select appropriate subroutines to calculate various features like circle, angle, straightness, etc. Manual zero setting for the three axis also we can observe. There is a touch trigger probe with A and B axis fixed to the Z axis probe bar. This demonstration shows the measurement of diameter, angle, straightness, flatness, perpendicularity, depth, and slot width.
All right, so this is our three-axis measuring machine. It's ideal for measuring some machine parts, as long as your tolerances aren't too tight, or laser, flame jet, water jet cut parts, those sorts of things. It's got a moving gantry, so this moves back and forth, towards and away from the operator, up and down. The touch probe has a number of articulating positions that you can lock it into. So, to do a measurement on a part like this, first thing we're going to want to do is measure the flat surface of the plane to get it aligned. Then we'll measure along an edge to get it straight. Then we'll set a point at the end and we'll make that corner our zero location. So, I'm going to bring the probe in. Take those. We'll just stay down here. And we'll come along the edge. Take those. And stay there. And we'll take that. And finish up. Now that we've taken our features, we can go to our display. So we can take that plane that we started with, go to the readout, we'll align that, so now it's flat, and we'll make that our z-axis zero location. We'll go to that edge we measured, we'll align that, and we'll make that our y-axis zero location. Now we'll go to that point that we measured, and make that our x-axis zero. So now, we're zero on that corner of the part where this edge, and that plane surface come out and intersect. Now all the features that we measure are going to be taken from that point. So we'll go ahead and probe a circle here. Stay there. We can go ahead and probe a circle here. And what I'm doing is just pressing the finish key when I've done taking my points, and the readout's going to figure out, based on the points I've taken, what those features are. So now we got a few features in the readout. We can come up, and we can construct a circle through the centers of those two holes and that arc that we just measured. So we'll measure a circle, we'll go into our feature list, and check each one of those. So we've got three features, we hit finish, now we get the circle that goes through those centers. We got an XY position for that and the diameter of that circle. Now on the part, if we want to see if that hole is concentric to this circle pattern, we can come in and check this hole location. Finish it up. And then up on the readout, we can go to a distance. We can select the last hole we measured and the hole we constructed. Hit finish. And that'll give us how far that XY position varies. To measure an angle on the part, we can come down and we'll probe one edge of the angle. We'll come in and probe the other edge of the angle. And up on the readout, we'll get a display as to what that angular measurement is. We can also pull up a view and visually see what the angle is. And we can change that to, you know, the different angle sets depending on which way our part's dimensioned. And we get varying angle measurements. When you're done with that, you can just hit the power button, hit the enter key a couple times. All those features disappear. We can check something else. So with this plasma cut part, we can do something very similar. Let's say we've got an alignment to the center line of this part. We can probe a line here. We can probe a line over here. And then up on the readout, we can create a line, select those two lines, and hit finish. And that gives us a midline in between the two. Since that's going to be the center of our part, we can go to the readout view, we can align it to that, and we can zero out our x-axis along that center line. And then we can check our feature measurements to that center line. So down on the part, we can come in and probe each of these hole locations. And up in the readout, we've got XY centers, we've got a diameter for each of those holes. We can create an arc feature or a circle feature from those and find out what the overall radius is and what the center point of that is as well. So you can check odd shaped laser cut or plasma cut, water jet cut parts using something like.
And next mode of operation is motorized computer assisted CMM. In this case, a joystick is used to drive the machine axis. You can see here we have a joystick. So this is moved in the three axes, x axis, y axis, and z axis. Accordingly, the probe will move. The operator manipulates the joystick to bring the probe into contact with the job. For example, so we have a hole in the workpiece surface. Then the operator will operate the joystick so that the probe moves in the z axis. That means it is inserted into the hole. Then it is moved in the x axis. So it makes contact here, and the coordinates of this point 1 are recorded, and then it is moved to this point by operating the joystick. So the data points of this particular point are recorded, then again it is moved in this direction and contact is made. And then the computer records the coordinates of this point, and then the software will calculate. So what is the coordinate of center point and what is the diameter of the hole? So like this, using computer, the manual calculations are eliminated, and the error due to operator is also eliminated. So this is faster when compared to manually operated CMM. Now the another configuration is direct computer controlled CMM. So this is a fully programmable CMM. In this case, the machine uses taught locations of CAD data to decide where the probe contacts the job and then collects the measurement data. That means the software itself will calculate what is the probe path. Probe path is calculated by the software by using the CAD data that is provided. That means how the probe should move. So that path is automatically calculated. The fully automated CMM allows the operator to place the job in a fixture or on a table and run the stored program, collect the data points and generate an output report. Now you can see here a fully programmable or direct computer controlled CMM. We have the monitor, and then we have the computer system, we have the keyboard, and then joysticks are also available, and this is a bridge type coordinate measuring machine with granite table. The complex work piece is directly mounted on the granite table, and the probe will move depending upon the program, inspection program. The probe will move and it collects the data points, and then necessary inspection report is generated by the software. So here operator error is completely eliminated. Since the path is calculated by the software, and the path is also optimized. Optimized path is calculated by the software so that the inspection time is very much less. And there are no chances of collision with the workpiece. Since the path is calculated by using the CAD data, the chances of collision of probe with workpiece are eliminated. Now let us study what are the different configurations of coordinate machine. The very most common configuration is bridge type coordinate measuring machine, wherein we have two columns here. As you can see here, there is a column here and there is two columns in this particular case, and there is a bridge between these columns. So bridge carries the probe head. This probe head can move up and down. So depending upon the workpiece height, the z-axis moment is calculated. Since the probe head is supported by two columns, the deflection of the bridge is very less. So these bridge type CMMs are most accurate. And this is the dedicated computer system interfaced with the coordinate measuring machine. Now here you can see a huge, gigantic coordinate measuring machine. This is the granite table on which very huge, large workpieces can be mounted. This is the column 1, column 2, and then we have the bridge which houses the probe head, and this is the probe. And we can also see the operator to operate the coordinate measuring machine. So very tiny bridge type coordinate measuring machines are also available. At the same time, gigantic coordinate measuring machines are also available to accommodate large workpieces. The another configuration is cantilever construction, which combines easy access and relatively small floor space requirement. It is typically limited to small and medium sized machines. I can see here the unlike the bridge type, so here this one side is completely open so that we can easily load the work pieces on the table from this open end. Parts larger than the machine table can be inserted into the open side without inhibiting full machine travel. So we have another type of configuration known as gantry type configuration. So wherein the probing head is held by fixed supports. Now you can see in this diagram we have fixed supports which will support the bridge. On these supports we have a guide beam. So this is one guide beam and this is another guide beam. So on these guide beams the bridge will move. Probing head is capable of sliding over the supports. The gantry type construction is particularly suited for very large components and allows the operator to remain close to the area of inspection. You can see here a motor bike is being inspected by a gantry type coordinate measuring machines. So other type of configuration is horizontal arm coordinate measuring machine. So wherein we have two columns in this particular type of machine. We have two columns and then there is a bridge and then there is an overhanging arm which supports the probe head. So in this case we have only one column and then an arm which supports the probing head. So this has an open end so we can insert large work pieces from this open end. The open structure of this arrangement provides optimum accessibility for large objects such as dies, models and cog bodies. Now in these diagrams we can see moving column type. This column can be moved in and out, and then we have a moving bridge type configuration. So depending upon the type of for pieces, we can select appropriate configuration. Now, what are the various parts of coordinate measuring machine? Now we have a main structure of coordinate measuring machine consisting of table, cantilever, bridge, column, gantry, horizontal arm and probe head. And then we have machine control unit with driving systems. There is a probing system, and then the automatic stylus changer is also there. Environmental monitoring system, which monitors the temperature using thermocouples. And then there is computer with CMM software to assess the workpieces. And then different kinds of accessories can be used during the inspection. So we have a joystick. I can see the joystick. By operating this, we can see the three directions, X, Y, and Z. In these directions, we can move the probe by operating this joystick. And there is an emergency button also to stop the movement in case of emergency. And then we have probe head and then stylus, driving system to move the columns, dust covers, granite table on which workpieces or work fixture can be mounted, thermocouples to sense the temperature variations. So like this, different parts are there in the CMM. And then there is a joystick. We can also see an automatic stylus changer which holds the stylus of different configurations depending upon the inspection. These probes are automatically selected and fixed into the probe head, and by operating the joystick, probe can be moved in the XYZ direction. We can see the joystick here, and then the granite table, and then we can also see the workpiece feature. Four workpiece features are more placed on the granite table, and the workpiece which is to be inspected is held by these four features. Typical machine working envelope, that means the size of the CMM, we have in the X direction movement 500 millimeter to 600 millimeter. In the Y direction, the movement is from 400 millimeter to 500 millimeter, and in the Z axis 400 to 440 millimeter with an accuracy of 0.1 micrometer. So this is a tiny CMM, and in the case of gantry type, the X, Y and Z axis movement will be in terms of meters with a measurement accuracy of 1 micrometer. Now you can see the automatic stylus changer system, which is directly placed onto the workpiece table. This holds the probes of different configurations and different lengths. You can also see a non-contact type probe, that is optical probe, or sometimes it is known as vision type probe. And here we can see a motorized the probe system and probes of different lengths. They can be mounted onto the stylus changer. Here you can see a spherical type or a ball type stylus. So depending upon the inspection requirement and depending upon the program, these probes are selected automatically and inspection is carried out. Then advanced path planning using software. So depending upon the CAD data that is provided, automatic probe angle is selected and path is also selected. You can see here, depending upon the workpiece, say we have a workpiece at some angle, a hole at some angle. So depending upon the data, CAD data provided, the probe attains this particular angle. So this angle is automatically selected by the CMM software. Also, what is the path of the stylus? So depending upon the CAD data that is provided, the probe movement path will be automatically calculated, and the collision with the workpiece is avoided. And then automatic collision detection is also possible using appropriate sensors. And once the path is determined, it is optimized depending upon the CAD data. Now you can see here, whenever we are using this multiple stylus type probe, when the probe moves in this XY and Z direction, this particular stylus should not touch the workpiece. So that care is taken by the CMM software. Now let us summarize the lecture number one. In this lecture, we discussed about the various aspects of universal measuring machine, and we also discussed about the features of coordinate measuring machine, different modes of operation of coordinate measuring machine, and different configurations of CMM and main parts of CMM. With this, we will conclude this lecture. We will continue the discussion on the different aspects of CMM in the next lecture. Thank you.